Agriculture is a backbone of India. 70% population in India stays in villages. India ranks at number 2 in the world in the farm output. In India, compared to agriculture sector, industries and commercial developments are on a good scale. Multiplex, malls, luxurious cars, but Indian farmers are yet waiting for some advanced technologies.
आम्ही या निगडे गावच्या ठाकरोस्तीमध्ये राहत असून या आदिवासींच्या हितासाठी एक पाणी योजना केली आहे. परंतु ही योजना करत असताना लाईट जाते त्यासाठी जनरेटरची आवश्यकता आहे, पाण्याची टाकीची आवश्यकता आहे, जमीन सपाटीकरण करण्याची आवश्यकता आहे, बी बियाण्याची आवश्यकता आहे. आदिवासींकडं पैसे नसून ते कर्जबाजारी झाल्यामुळे आत्महत्याच्या आरी जाऊन आत्महत्या करतात. शासनाकडे एकच विनंती, एका पूर्तता करून पूर्तता करावी.
It is a need that the technocrats and technologies must penetrate the distant locations of India. I have been from the farmer's family and I have witnessed and experienced my family problems related to farming. I have seen my grandfather visiting to the water pump during midnight at 2 o'clock, and I have been with him so many times, and I usually asked him, why dadaji we are coming here during night period? So simple answer was from my grandfather, there was no power supply during the whole day, and now we have to switch on our pump set because we want to irrigate our oranges. As far as irrigation is concerned, water pumps are located at the distant places, maybe 1 to 10 kilometers from their house or from the farms, and the pumps are located in hazardous conditions, animals on the way, difficult terrain. They need a vehicle or an operator for switching on of the pump sets. No electricity for many of the times for the whole day. They have to travel during night period. So everything is dangerous.
मिस्टर, माझे जेव्हा नदीवर चालू केलेली मोटार बंद करायला जातात तेव्हा मी घरामध्ये एकटीच असते आणि आमचा जंगलाचा एरिया असल्यामुळे मला खूप भीती वाटते. तेही तिथपर्यंत मी जागीच राहते, झोप लागत नाही.
Though I have experienced farming challenges after becoming electronics and electrical engineer, my vision towards technology was broadened, and I thought that with the help of technology I can surely solve the problems in the irrigation with the help of different electronics and electrical tools. So I focused myself on developing electronic tools for solving the problems in irrigation. Nano Ganesh is a mobile based remote control set by using which a farmer can control their water pump set from any place with the help of a simple mobile phone. He can understand whether power supply is available or not there at the water pump end. He can also understand whether pump has been started or not. In few models, farmers gets SMS alerts if anybody opens the starter, if there is any fault in the electricity. So this has been quite useful for the farmers.
शेती म्हणजे आमचं जीवन आहे आणि मला असं वाटतं की आमच्या जीवनाचे रिमोट कंट्रोल आमच्या हातात आहे.
अशी आधुनिक टेक्नॉलॉजीची प्रचारासाठी आर्थिक बजेट नसतो तेव्हा प्रत्येक गावात जाऊन आमच्यासारखे ग्राउंड कमांडो प्रत्येक शेतकऱ्याला आधुनिक टेक्नॉलॉजीचं महत्त्व समजवतात.
हा मोबाईल स्टार्टर आहे.
हा पंप चालू करण्यासाठी एक कॉल करायचा आणि एक कोड नंबर टाकायचा तेव्हा पंप चालू होतो.
एका शेतकऱ्याने एक प्रोडक्ट घेतलं त्याचं महत्त्व त्याला समजलं तेव्हा तो दुसऱ्या शेतकऱ्याला सांगतो आणि तेव्हा माझं काम झालं.
फार महाग आहे का एवढा महाग नाही आहे. एका वेळेला इन्स्टॉलेशन केल्यानंतर 5,500 रुपयात सगळं होऊन जातं.
वी हॅव इन्स्टॉल्ड 25,000 नॅनो गणेश युनिट्स बेनिफिटिंग 2 लाख ऑफ फार्मर्स. इनिशियली नंबर वॉज व्हेरी लेस पण इन रिसेंट 5 इयर्स द नंबर हॅज ग्रोन क्वाईट अ बिट.
माझी मोटर मोबाईलवर चालू झाली आहे आणि याच्यावरच परत बंद करता येते.
मेरे रिलेटिव्हसको मैंने देखा उसके वहां नैनो गणेश लगाया है. पहले तो मेरे को विश्वास नहीं होता था कि ऐसे हो सकता है करके जाके देखा. उसके बाद में मैं सोच में पड़ गया कि ये गॉड गिफ्ट है अपने लिए.
Nano Ganesh technology was installed initially in Maharashtra and then we spread across the country in Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, even we reached to Assam. One international organization has already on the way of publishing Nano Ganesh profile and they want to take Nano Ganesh technology across 84 countries. Across 84 developing countries in the world. We could understand the feelings of the farmers. We could understand the pains their families facing. So naturally, we learnt a lot from this. I'll tell you very important that we are not born here just for ourselves. We are born here for the benefit of the society. This is a big lessons we learned in the journey of my Nano Ganesh developments. Me and my wife are founders of Nano Ganesh and Ocean Group, and we are right now a team of 16 people, and we have decided to empower the rural community in all the dimensions of Nano Ganesh, right from 0 to 100.
This number should be configured on 161, no? Because that Ramnagar can be immediately tested then. For half an hour they are providing supply right now.
India is a developing country and yet 80% of the population is in base of the pyramid. So to understand the base of the pyramid, we must educate them, we must empower them, we must give them energy in different way like health, education, money, food. If a social thought is there, then only you can think of empowering this base of the pyramid. So India is very important in this criteria. We want to empower the BOP. One secret I would tell, what I learned in my whole journey, you know, if you think for the globe, if you think for the bigger world, then nature offers you something wonderful, something exciting. And I did experience in last 15 years, every time there is some miraculous thing happening about Nano Ganesh. So I think everybody must think of somebody helping others, or how he will be useful for the world. Then you just see a miracle, how divine, how nature works for you. This is a formula. Nature always says you work for me, I will work for you.